Okay, this is JDS. Welcome back to another video. Sport Talks is back, kind of, not really. As you would have seen, I'm not going to use the little side, or for this side for you guys, what a side is, the side thingy for the thumbnail, because I don't like the one we've got currently, and I'm not going to use it until I get a better one. It just looks shit. So if you don't know what I mean, don't worry. If you want to know, just go into my videos and look through all the thumbnails. The bit on the right side of the thumbnail is what I'm talking about. First game of the season, Carlton versus Richmond. It is a draw, 58-58, I think. Should know, I just watched it. Pretty topsy-turvy game, flipping and flopping throughout the, like, who's in control of the game, who's probably going to win. I did personally tip Carlton to win the game. And they probably should have, really. I would say both teams looked a bit unpolished. Probably Carlton, they looked evenly unpolished, to be honest. I know it's the first game of the season, but they look pretty unpolished. I reckon they're both going to be upper middle table by the end of the year, because they both look, they had that whole look good, then do something completely ridiculous and stupid, or just really clean, really smooth through the middle, and then all of a sudden doing something scrappy. That kind of play, which you see from like the middle table teams. Carlton came out strong, took control of the game, didn't look in full control. Probably Richmond, probably by the end of the first quarter, probably did have the more control of the game. But when it mattered, when it came down to the times where scoring was done in the game, it was Carlton who had control. I felt like they generally, despite not always having control of general play, because they were in front, they had that. They had that from early in the game. They had control of it, even though general play wasn't going in their favour, because they were quite strong in defence and Richmond weren't very good going forwards. McKay, like, he didn't play that badly in the end. This is Carlton, if you didn't know. McKay, he's kicking inside 50 is not good, like, at all. Kicking inside 50 is very interesting. There was quite a few who just weren't to his team's advantage. One thing I've just got to talk about, Bolton. What the fuck are you doing? If you don't know what I'm talking about, imagine this is the goal square. Let me turn this downwards. So, let's get just one of these things. Imagine that is the goal square. Bolton is probably, 25? I'm not really set to do this. Wasn't planning on doing this, but I'm going to do it anyway. So Bolton's probably like 25 directly out in front from the goal square. Yeah, something like that. Doesn't make any sense, don't worry. Directly in front, 25 out. He kicks the ball around the corner. Like, directly in front, 25 out. He does a snap, shanks it and misses. What the fuck are you doing? Why are you snapping it? A snap is for a tight angle. This happens so much, I don't mind that much. It's stupid how often it happens, not tight angles get snapped. I get the idea, cut down the angle, but this one, he was literally directly in front and he still snapped the ball. Like, a drop punt is more accurate until, like, at least beyond 45 degrees. Snapping is too easy to hit the wrong part of the ball, kick it straight, or just not get it cool enough. A drop punt is the kick to do directly in front. I don't know why I have to say that. Why are you snapping the ball? I shouldn't care. I tipped Carlton to win. But it's just, what's the term? It's cardinal sin. It's a term I can't think of. It's just wrong. What the fuck are you doing? We're playing footy. Why are you snapping the ball directly in front? Would you snap the ball if you're kicking the dusties through the middle? 25 meters away from him? No, you would go straight on, kick it straight to him. Because it's a more accurate kick. What are you doing? Anyway, last quarter, obviously, Richmond come back into it. I think it was late second, no, it was early third quarter. They came back into the game, got five goals pretty quickly to Carlton's one in the first like 10 minutes, 15 minutes of the quarter. And it sort of fizzled out to not much in the last bit of the quarter. Last quarter was heavily in Richmond's favour in terms of general play, but Carlton doing enough to stay in it and having a few good minutes of play, which got them back ahead. And then it was even. I actually forgot how it came even. There was obviously a Richmond goal because they were a goal behind. But there was some mess up from memory from Carlton that caused it to become even. And even actually early with Shea Bolton in the game, giving away a stupid 50, just give the ball back. Anyway, enough about him. Yeah, there was, for memory, there was some mistake by Carlton. I can't actually remember. I wasn't planning on doing this video until after the game had happened. Some mistake that caused Richmond to get the goal that even up. I can't remember, as I said. And then last minute, Carlton have put out the sign, which is a power button, which we're all assuming, because it makes sense, is shut the game down. No more scoring, because they were in front. Then obviously that goal happened, and then they had the chance to go forward. They got a breakaway, and you have three players like this with McKay in the middle, straight over the heads, perfectly to McKay. The other guys are wrong-footed, can't get to the ball. McKay slips over, drops the mark. Then Richmond go down the other end and score. That was how it was even, because it was a draw, not a win to Richmond. It feels like it was a win to Richmond, because it should have been a win for Carlton. Yeah, so that's how it happened. Ball went over the top. McKay should have marked it, but he stacked it. Still almost marked it, to be fair, but stacked it. Dropped the mark, went down the other end, scored a goal. Then they had another chance to maybe get a mark with like 4 seconds to go. Someone again losing their balance, failed to mark the ball. He could have probably talked it through, got any kind of score from a torp. And, or even just a drop punt, just launch as far as you can, make sure it gets between the at least the four sticks, it's a win. But he failed to mark the ball, and then it was game. Wasn't really much of a detailed analysis, it was just sort of like a ramble. I've not done a sport talks in a serious sport talks in this sense in a long time. Normally I sort of plan a little bit in my head first, but this I just sort of turned the camera on and went for it. Yeah. Opening round of the season. A point for each team. 58 apiece. Let's see what happens with the rest of the games. I reckon, who is the next game? I actually don't know who's playing tomorrow. I know North Melbourne, West Coast. We're just going to talk about that for a little bit. I picked West Coast, but I'm not that confident that West Coast are going to win. Because we've got injuries, although when we haven't, we had injuries. We've had injuries and COVID stuff last year. We've basically not had a season going into it without major injuries after at least the first two rounds. For as long as I can remember. I know that's just footy, but like we've had it bad for a long time. And normally it does as well, because the young players get a chance to do something and actually get into the squad and get actual play time and develop, which helps us in the long run. Getting us premierships like 2018, where players that no one really knew were that good, because they weren't as far as we knew, but because the young players got a chance to shine then, because we had a good team. And we got a bit of luck with the draw with Richmond getting knocked out by Collingwood. Thanks, Mason. And we won. So it's probably good for us again in the long run, but it's just painful always having to be on the back foot with injuries, plus not being that great anyway these days. A lot of the old guys are getting too old, and now a few of them are retired. Young guys coming in that probably aren't good enough, probably not made very good picks and trades recently. Sheffield Seaton, not a good trade. Anyway. I don't remember who I picked. Let's see who the next game is. I'll just quickly search it up. Okay, the next game is Geelong Cats versus the Pies. I definitely picked the Cats. They're at home. They're better than the Geelong Pies. Geelong Pies. Collingwood Magpies. Geelong should win. Even though they've lost a few guys, they are quite old. I think they should still win. They're still easy, better than the Pies in my opinion. So that should be, I reckon, 20-point win. Probably quite close to the third quarter. Then Geelong will pull away. Basic footy stuff, I reckon. I'd assume it'd be at GMHBA because it's early in the season. They always play there. That being their home ground, no, I can't actually see what ground they're at here. Oh no, it's the MCG. I don't get that. Is GMHBA still under construction or something? Why aren't they playing at GMHBA? Anyway, thanks, bye. See ya. It's never too late to start a new beginning. That goes for you too. So what the fuck you gonna do? Use the tools you're given, or you gonna use the card you dealt? It's an excuse for you to not do shit with them. I used to play the loser victim till I saw the way proof was driven. I found my vehicle and I haven't ran out of gas yet. And when they stack decks, turn handicaps into assets, fanny packs, hourglasses. If time was on my side, I'd still have none to waste. Man, am I young?